हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम भारती शिंदे, वर्किंग एज अ लेक्चरर इन प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज। इन दिस वीडियो यू विल सी फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ अप्लाइड मैकेनिक्स एंड द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज इक्विलिब्रियम। सो वी विल सी इक्विलिब्रियम एंड एनालिटिकल एंड ग्राफिकल कंडीशंस ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इक्विलिब्रियम इज defined as a body is said to be in equilibrium when the resultant of several forces acting on it is zero. So the forces acting on the body is zero, then the body is said to be as in equilibrium. So for that there is a analytical and graphical conditions. So first condition, first analytical condition is sum of components in x direction must be zero, that is summation fx is equals to zero. Second condition, summation fy is equals to zero, that is sum of forces in y direction. And summation m is equals to zero, that is moments about any point must be zero. And graphical conditions as the force polygon must be closed by itself and funicular polygon must be closed by itself. So force polygon and funicular polygon will draw, and that polygon must be closed is the graphical condition. Next we will see analytical condition of equilibrium for concurrent force system. So for concurrent force system there are two conditions, summation fx is equals to zero and summation fy is equals to zero. Then summation fx is nothing but forces in x direction, and summation fy is forces along y direction. Analytical conditions of equilibrium for non-concurrent force system as summation fx is equals to 0, summation fy is equals to 0, and summation m is equals to 0. That is moments of forces along any point. Then we will see the comparison of resultant and equilibrium. So resultant is defined as a single force which produces the same effect on body as produced by several forces. As we know, resultant have the properties or have the effect which is same as the other forces acting on the body. And equilibrium is defined as the single force which keeps the body in equilibrium. Then second point, resultant causes displacement of body, but equilibrium causes body to remain at rest. So when we will see body is in equilibrium, then it is at rest, and resultant causes the displacement of the body. Then we will see relation between resultant and equilibrium. So resultant and equilibrium are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, as we have seen this in previous chapter. So resultant causes displacement of body, whereas equilibrium causes the body to remain in equilibrium. Then we will see free body diagram. So when all active and reactive forces acting on free body are shown, and thus the diagram obtained is called as free body diagram. So when all active and reactive forces acting on free body are shown, that is here all forces are shown, and the diagram we obtained is called as free body diagram. So this phase A is here, phase B, and weight is nothing but 500 newton. As we know, weight always acts downwards, so we have shown weight W as downward. Then this reaction, that is this phase B having reaction here which is RB, which is in this direction, and here RA. So we have shown RA as along this direction. Then you will see, based on that, Lami's theorem is there. So Lami's theorem states that if three forces acting at a point on a body keeps it at rest, then each force is proportional to the sine of the angle between other two forces. Suppose this is the given diagram, then as per Lami's theorem, the formula is this F1 divided by angle between other two forces, that is angle between forces F2 and F3. So F1 divided by sine alpha, then automatically is equals to F2 divided by sine beta, and this F3 divided by sine gamma. So we have taken angles as alpha, beta, gamma. Then there are some limitations of Lami's theorem. So first limitation is this theorem applicable only if body is in equilibrium. Then second limitation is the theorem is not applicable for parallel or non-concurrent force system. Then the theorem is not applicable for more or less than three concurrent forces. And theorem is not applicable for non-coplanar forces. So for Lami's theorem, we will need only three forces, as it is not applicable for more than three or less than three concurrent forces. And forces must be concurrent, that is it will meet at point 1. So for non-concurrent forces, this theorem is not applicable. And for non-coplanar forces also, it is not applicable. Then we will see beam and its type. So beam is defined as a structural member which transfers load on supports. So beam transfers load on supports. Then we will see types of beams along with sketch. So first is simply supported beam. The beam supported on the ends which are free to rotate and have no moment resistance. So this is simply supported beam, as beam supported on ends. Then cantilever beam. So here projecting beam fixed only at one end. In cantilever beam, beam is fixed only at one end and other end is free. Overhanging beam is simple beam extending beyond its support on one end. So here we can see simple beam extending beyond its supports. Here also it is extended on both sides. Then fixed beam, so beam supported on both ends and restrained from rotation. So here beam is fixed at both ends, so it is called as fixed beam. Then continuous beam, so beam extending over more than two supports. So for continuous beam, there are more than two supports. So here are total three supports. So it is about the type of beams. Now we will see type of loads. So type of loads can be applied to beams are first concentrated or point load. So it acts at a point whether in vertical or inclined direction. We will call it as point load. So it acts at a point vertically or inclined direction. As this is vertical, this is also vertical, but this is inclined, having some angle theta here. Now, next we will see uniformly distributed load, or in shortcut is it called as UDL. So load spread along the length of the beam. So uniformly distributed load is like this. So it is spread along the length of the beam. Then couple. So coupled load is that in which two equal and opposite forces acts on the same span. The lines of action of both the forces are parallel to each other but opposite in direction. So it is not couple is nothing but having the property of resultant and equilibrium. That is, the two equal and opposite forces act on same span, and the line of action of both the forces are parallel to each other but opposite in direction. Then, types of end supports also there on beams. So these supports are roller support, hinged support, and fixed support. First, we will see movable support, or it is also called as roller support. So, roller support is like this, or like this, as these are the wheels, round wheels. Then, hinged support. So, hinged support is like this. And fixed support is like this. Now we will see the numericals on these supports and types of beams.